Welcome back, everybody. Oh, take a deep breath, because here to show us how to truly bring spring into the air with her DIY dried flower room fresheners is Allie.
Hi, yes. Hi. Oh my gosh, aren't these so pretty?
They're
I'm incredibly obsessed with them.
Beautiful.
You know, I had the idea because everyone's doing spring cleaning right now, right?
Sure.
Me and everyone out there. And I was putting air freshener in the room and I realized, oh my gosh, I looked at the label, I'm like, there's a lot of chemicals in this. And I thought there's gotta be a better way to do it and more natural way. And so I came up with this.
There's literally things on those labels that you can't even begin to pronounce.
Absolutely.
Right? That can't be a good thing.
No, and especially I have two little kids, so putting anything in the air that I don't know what it is, I'm weird about that.
So that's A, smart because of that, and B, they just look so incredibly pretty. So let's get started. What's the first thing that we need to do here?
Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're just going to melt down some wax flakes.
You can
just buy these, melt them down. I've melted down 3 cups of them.
Okay.
And they melt down like this. And then we're going to add our essential oil. So you can add any essential oil that you want, depending on the scent that you
Nice.
Right? So if you like peppermint, use that. If you, like lavender, I love lavender, especially for my kiddos, because lavender is soothing. It helps them go to sleep at night. I actually put a little lavender on the bottom of their feet before they go to bed.
So did I with my kids.
You did?
Yes,
it worked.
It's so nice. Brings me back. Let's use lavender then today.
Yes, that's what we're going to do, because you could put these in your kiddo's room and it will smell nice and you know there's nothing bad going in there.
Which guy's the lavender?
This one right here.
Okay, so how much do we know? Like, how much do we put in there?
Okay, so you're going to put in 50 drops. And I know that sounds like a ton of essential oil. Like, usually if you put it on your skin, you do like one drop and it's plenty. But these, you want this scent to last, right? And you want it to freshen a whole room. So I'm telling you, 50, you could even probably use more. So yeah, you'll just drop it in. I'm not going to take the time to count out 50 right now. But about 50 drops in
You'll figure out how much is in one dropper, and then it'll speed the whole thing up.
I was going to say, it's about 6 droppers, I think.
You stir that up.
Yes, you can stir it up, and then you're going to put it into your mold.
Are you waiting for me to do that? You're standing there like you're going to pour, and I'm like, you're going to trust me with like hot wax pouring into these molds?
So these molds right here, you just want to pour it in probably till it's about 75% of the way full.
Okay.
And the reason you don't want to do it all the way is that when the wax cools down, it will expand a little bit. And we're going to be adding dried flowers to this. So when you add the dried flowers, it will also add, some stuff to it, and it will overflow.
These cool sort of malleable molds that we're using. But could you do this without using some of these molds?
Yes. No, you absolutely could. I liked these molds because they had these little, if you see these little knobs.
Yes.
So that's what we're going to put our ribbon through to hang them.
Got it.
But yes, if you don't have these, you could use, the silicone cupcake makers that you make cupcakes in.
Sure.
You could do it in there. And then all I would do is I would take a straw and make it short so it's not hanging all the way up, and just cut the straw and put it in the top, and that will create the little hole.
That's a good idea.
I actually did. I tried to do it with a cookie cutter, right? Like a round cookie cutter and with parchment paper, but I found it was kind of leaking out the bottom. But if all you have is a cookie cutter and parchment paper, you could do it, put the wax in, and then put a book on top to weight it down.
To seal the bottom onto
the
parchment paper.
And then you might have to trim it after if it leaks out at all. But yeah, you could totally do that.
Lots of options. So now we've got our wax, our melted wax in here with the fragrance, and now comes the flowers. But how soon or how later do we put the flowers in? How do we know when?
Yeah, no, that's a really good question. Because if you put them in too soon, so if you pour the wax and you just dump the flowers right in, you're going to end up with something like this.
That is
so
what I would
This is an experiment when I started, and I just put the flowers in right away. And as you see, they all kind of sunk to the bottom, and then a coating came over the top, and it's just not nearly as pretty, right?
No, it's not.
If you have a larger flower, like over here on these ones that are done, this large flower you can put in right away because it's so big that it's not going to sink through, right? So that's okay if you add those right away. But I would still wait for the wax to set a minute because they'll stay right in place if you let it set for just a second. So there's kind of like a film over the top.
Got it.
And then that way you can place even your smaller flowers then, and they won't sink down through. So
that's a good tip. This would be good for soap. Like, this looks like it might be like a bar of soap that you made at home,
right,
but not for air freshener. Very good.
We want this prettiness.
How long do we let them cool? How does the cooling technique
work? It depends on the size of your mold.
Okay.
So it's totally different. But if you wanted to speed it up, like if you had a really thick mold that you were using, you just pop it into the fridge, and it will go so much quicker.
Beautiful.
So here, let's try. This isn't really quite set up yet,
okay,
so these might fall through, but I kind of just want to show you.
Can I try some of these guys?
And you can mix it up, put a lemon in one, and then some flowers, or you could make a whole thing of flowers. What I really like about this, actually, say, we're always thinking Christmas here at Hallmark.
Yes, of course.
Say you wanted to make these for your Christmas tree, you could use a pine essential oil put little pine needles from your tree and then hang them in your tree, and it would smell like a real tree if you had an artificial tree. Cool, right?
Great idea, and look how talented I am. That is beautiful.
Wow, you really nailed it.
I said that out loud, didn't I? I said that out loud. Okay, so they're cool, we got. Yes. Now it's time to pop them out of the molds.
Yeah, so all you do is pop them out of the molds. You wanna do it gently because you don't want them to crack. I would come at it from like a few different angles to kind of get them to come out nicely.
Ooh, nice.
There we go, see?
Nice.
Beautiful, right?
This guy right here.
Okay, you
see
got
if
it?
I can do this.
Yeah. It should come out good.
Oh, you did it.
Good job.
Nice.
And then all we do, the little hole in the top I was telling you about. Yeah. All you do is you take a piece of ribbon.
Okay.
Here you go. Oh, you got one.
I got one.
And you just put it through.
Just like this, everybody.
Yeah.
Let me just smell this guy first.
How's it smell?
Oh, beautiful.
Right? It's so nice. And then you tie a knot on the top, and you can hang it anywhere. Like I said, you can hang it on a plant, a tree, a nail, anywhere in your house, a knob.
I love your Christmas tree idea.
Isn't that fun? Yeah, and then I feel like even too, like these are so beautiful and easy to make that if you're getting married, you can make them as, you know, favors for your guests, for a bridal shower, for a baby shower, for, you know, your bridesmaids, and they're really inexpensive and beautiful.
I think this is a fantastic idea.
Well, thank you.
Look what I just made, sort of, kind of, without helping everybody.
You did. You did a good job.